In our last video, we did an intro to LINQ, and in this video, we're going to talk about the query LINQ syntax. So, Bill, we spoke about where and select, so what's next?
Well, there's a whole lot more. When I'm exploring LINQ, I often like to try to find things that I don't use every day, because that's the stuff I often forget. Where should we start?
Should we start with skip and take?
Skip and take is perfect. So partition operators. Let's go into that page. Which one do you want me to try first?
Let's try the first one.
All right, so we've got a set of numbers. And it's a method call syntax, so we're going to take three. So I would figure that might do something like...
Oh, so that returned the first set of results.
Right, so it's got just three. I usually think this is great for prototyping.
All right, let's try the next one.
Let's try the next one.
Scroll down.
So we've got a nested take. This is interesting to me. I'm seeing query syntax, that from and from again, and a where clause, which we talked about before, and then a select. And then it's closing, and then it's calling take.3.
So it uses a method syntax as well.
So it's mixing the two together, method syntax and query syntax. So I've now got these records of the first three orders. Is that normal, mixing them like that? Is there any penalties there?
I don't know. Yeah, I was wondering if there is any penalty for performance.
Actually, because take and because that query syntax maps directly to method calls, there's no penalty whatsoever. Where should we go next?
Let's go to the next page.
All right. Next page is partitions with conditions.
Awesome. Let's do the take while syntax.
Okay, so now I've got this numbers.take while as long as n is less than 6. So if I hit that, now we see we've got the first numbers less than 6, so it does 5, 4, 1, 3. So this is kind of like a where, but if I look later in my sequence, there's a 2 and a 0, and I didn't get those.
Yeah, when would I use that?
Well, this one lets me look at a condition, and then I'm only going to take from the beginning of the sequence until that condition is false, and then I stop.
Okay, so I can take no more than, let's say, 10 elements while condition is true.
Right, so I can kind of explore data a little bit, but not get a whole lot, because I'm not sure exactly how much is there, and I'm just kind of exploring a little bit.
Cool.
Where should we try next?
Yeah, should we try something else? Should we go back to the home?
Let's go back home. So at the bottom, we've got the LINQ back up to home. Where should we go?
Should we do the sequence operations?
Sequence operations. That one's down near the bottom. We're skipping around a lot. We're leaving a lot for people to do on your own. So sequence operations. All right, so this first one compares two sequences for equality. So I've got a couple different arrays, and right now they match. I've got some code here it wants me to try by changing the second one, just by putting a couple in, changing the order of a couple of these. So now I've switched up the order between the apple and the blueberry and the cherry. And if I try it this time, now they don't match.
Oh, right. So they have to match pretty much.
They have to match exactly the same elements and the same elements in the same location for sequences to be equal.
Great. Should we try the last one?
Last one is combining sequences with zip. That sounds a little different.
Yeah, what does zip do?
Okay, so what zip does is it takes two different vectors, the first one 0, 2, 4, 5, 6, and in succession matches each element with an element from the second vector, that 1, 3, 5, 7, 8. So the input is the 0 and the 1, the 2 and the 3, the 4 and the 5, and then the 5 and the 7. You know, this pair, just this pair here, the 0 with that 1, and then the 2 and the 3, and like moving through each of the sequences one at a time. And building one output sequence from that, and then it sums all those values together. So where would I use something like this?
Maybe an IoT application where you can compare data and take in on successive days.
So I get data from Monday, I get data from Tuesday, and I can look at things at the same time on those two successive days. That would be cool.
Great. Should we try one more?
Let's try one more. Where should I go?
Let's go back to the home.
Back to home?
Let's try combine multiple input sequences under the projection operators.
So back under select, and we're going to go to combine multiple input sequences. So this is new. I've got two from clauses in this one. I've got from something in numbers A, from something in numbers B, then we've got a where, and I'm doing a select.
What do they do?
And what this thing says it does is it is going to find every pair where the first one is less than the second one. So I've got a number of elements in here. And it looks like what it's doing is it's comparing everything in the first sequence to everything in the second. Let's make one change up here. Let's just remove this where clause and kind of see exactly what those two from clauses do. So instead of filtering it, we're going to get everything. And if I do it that way, now I kind of like this. I'm seeing this, you know, zero, and then, which is the first element, numbers A, paired with that 1, 3, 5, 7, and 8 in sequence from, you know, everything in sequence B, and then the next one in A, and the next one in B. So it kind of builds this big cross-section of all the possible XY pairs, you know, between those two sequences.
Right, so because the first array has 7 elements and the second array has 5, the output sequence would have 35 elements before filtering and using the where clause.
Right, so we put the where clause back in, and then we get only those pairs where that that condition of the first number being smaller than the second one is true.
Awesome, so this is a great resource to learn more about LINQ.
It is, there's a whole lot of different things you can show. We looked at some of the syntax here, but there's a lot more. And in the next video, we're going to show you some things about how LINQ queries execute in terms of how they produce their results and how you can plug different pieces of LINQ together to build more complicated queries. We'll see you then.